let us discuss yung concept muna ng direct quotation. Okay? So, mag-ingat ka sa problem, baka kasi ang ipakita po dun sa problem ay naka-indirect quote. Okay? Ganito po ang simpleng concept ng direct quotation. Pag direct quotation, yung local currency or domestic currency nasa numerator at yung foreign currency nasa denominator. Okay, say for example, ang palitan na ng peso sa dollar, say for example lang, ay 55 pesos is to $1. Okay? O kaya naman 50 pesos is to $1. 45 pesos is to $1. So sa perspective ng domestic corp, okay, which is yung Philippine corporations, 50 peso is to 1 ay naka-direct quote po yan. Okay? So ibig sabihin, since ang denominator ay yung foreign currency, direct quote po kay domestic corp yan. Pero pag binaliktad natin, okay, 1 peso divided by, rather $1 divided by 50 pesos, so that is 0.02. Okay? Dollars is to 1 peso, binaliktad mo na, no? Yung peso ang nasa denominator, okay? And that is now the indirect quote. So, dito sa problem letter A, if 50 peso can be exchanged for $1, what is the direct quotation expressed in Philippine peso? Ang sagot po natin, okay, letter A. 50 is to 1. Okay? So yan po yung direct quote. Kasi ang local currency natin ay nasa numerator. Yung $1, yan naman yung foreign currency unit. Yan po yung direct quote. Okay? Expressed in Philippine peso. But if direct quote naman, class, direct pa rin, ha? Hindi po indirect yung ginamit kong word. Okay? Expressed in US dollar. So sa perspective naman ng foreign corporation, okay? Yan, a foreign corp naman to, class, no? Okay? Example, US firm. Ang kanyang direct quotation will be 0.02 US dollar is to 1 peso. Okay? Kasi perspective na ni foreign corp yan. Ito naman perspective ni domestic corp. And okay, so ito po yan. So direct quotation is when the foreign currency unit is the base amount or denominator. Indirect quotation is when the local currency unit is the base amount or denominator. So ibig sabihin, kung mag-i-indirect quote po tayo dito, itong 0.02 is to 1 peso, indirect quote po sa perspective ni Philippine Corporation or Domestic Corp. Ito naman pong 50 peso is to $1, yan naman yung indirect quote in the perspective of, okay, foreign corporation. Ganyan po, ha? Okay? Para hindi po tayo malito, ang direct quotation ay LCU over FCU, foreign currency. So, ayan po. 50 is to 1. That is the direct quote for Philippine or domestic corp. And 0.02 is to 1. Direct quote po yan ni foreign corp. Indirect quote naman yan ni domestic corporation. So what is the effect, sir, kapag kaganito? Okay? Sa concept class, kapag tumataas ang value, okay, or exchange rate na naka-direct quotation from 50 pesos is to $1, naging 55, humihina po, nagde-depreciate yung value ng peso. Di ba? Pero kapag naka-indirect quote, baliktad, nag-a-appreciate naman po kapag ka tumataas yung indirect quote ng Philippine peso is to dollar. Okay, so ngayon, class, mag-ingat lang. Kasi baka sa problem, instead na naka-direct quote, indirect quote muna yung pinakita. Okay, so may advice, quick note natin, i-convert mo muna yung indirect quote to direct quotation. So LCU muna over FCU bago ka mag-compute ng forex gain or loss. Okay? So that's for direct and indirect. So suggested answer natin, again, letter A and letter D. Yan. Okay, so that in all persons and things, God may be glorified. Okay? And lagi kong nire-recognize, no, itong ating verse sa Bible, Mark 11:24. Therefore, I tell you, okay, whatever you ask for through prayers, believe that you have received it and it will be yours. Okay? When I took the board examination, bar examination, okay, dapat, no, maniwala muna ako na magiging CPA ako, magiging lawyer ako. Okay? And of course, i-claim mo. Yan. So yun ang ginawa po natin, okay? Nagdasal po tayo, and of course, with action. And ito po, to give back sa kay Lord, okay, sa blessings na ito, and I am now conducting, okay, itong humble initiative natin na free webinar or lecture, okay, to extend, okay, assistance, okay, knowledge or help sa mga aspiring, okay, BSA students and CPA reviewees in order for you to achieve your objectives or goal of becoming a CPA. So yun po, no, ang ating initiative, kaya meron po tayong lecture series na ganito. Okay? So aside from this, nakita nyo class, we have a FAR Quick Notes 2023 edition. Lumabas siya noong September 23, 2022. Okay? At sa inyo na nag-attend ng ating webinar, okay, lecture series dito sa ating Forex transaction na lecture, at nag-register, no? I have the list of registrants, okay? 450 plus po yung nag-register. Thank you for registering. And of course, to give back, no? If you are interested sa ating textbook to learn more, okay, on AFAR Quick Notes from partnership hanggang cost accounting, build, operate, transfer, insurance, okay, ay magbibigay po tayo ng discount, okay, sa mga nag-register ngayon at nag-attend. Ito po yung ating promo code. Okay? I would just like to emphasize, okay, na meron po tayong 50 peso discount doon sa ating textbook. Okay? Just register doon sa link na i-email ko sa inyo, mga kapatid. Ayan. Okay, doon sa registered email ninyo. And input nyo lang po itong promo code so that I can give you a discount. Sa mga conditional, okay, conditional examinee ng LECPA, of course, isang subject na lang naman po ito, AFAR, okay? I am extending a discount amounting to 100 pesos dito sa libro natin. Okay? Of course, you have to present na lang class yung proof, okay? And tiyaga lang. Okay, magiging CPA din po tayo. Yan. So again, thank you for attending our lecture series. Okay, this is part one of our Forex transaction and translation lecture series. Okay, watch out at abangan na lang po yung second schedule ng webinar natin, at i-discuss natin yung with hedging, at yung pangatlo ay translation. Okay, so thank you and good evening sa inyong lahat.